Hello, in this video we're going to look at consumer theory, doing some sample test math questions. Question one, the consumer's utility function is given by u equals x squared times y. List three consumption bundles that are on the indifference curve for u equals 100. First thing we're going to do is set u equal to 100, and then we're going to solve this for y, so dividing through by x squared. Now let's put a table together and put in various values for x. So if x is 1, 100 divided by 1 squared gives us a y value of 100. This is one consumption bundle that lies on an indifference curve for u equals 100. Notice that if we plug x equals 1 and y equals 100 into this utility function, I'll show the math here, utility would equal 100. Let's get another consumption bundle. Let's plug in 2 for x. So 100 divided by 2 squared is 100 divided by 4, or 25. So x equals 2 and y equals 25 is another consumption bundle that gives the consumer exactly 100 units of satisfaction. And for our third consumption bundle, we'll plug 10 in for x. So 100 divided by 10 squared is just 1. And as we can see here, the utility is 100 at x equals 10 and y equals 1. Problem 2, a consumer's utility function is given by the following. We're going to solve for the marginal rate of substitution and interpret its value at x equals 3 and y equals 18. What is the marginal rate of substitution? It is the marginal utility of good x divided by the marginal utility of good y. Let's get the marginal utility of good x. We're going to take the partial derivative of the utility function with respect to x. So x squared here, we're going to bring down the 2 in front. That's where the 2x is coming from. We're going to subtract 1 from that exponent on the x term. So 2 minus 1 just leaves us with x. And we don't do anything with y to the fourth power. That is the marginal utility of good x. The marginal utility of good y, we're going to look at this y to the fourth power here. Going to bring down the 4 in front, so that's where this 4 is coming from. Don't need to do anything with x squared. We are going to subtract 1 from this exponent on the y term. That's why we got y raised to the third power, 4 minus 1. Now just forming the marginal rate of substitution, marginal utility of good x divided by the marginal utility of good y, and simplifying, we get this result here, y divided by 2x. Notice 2 divided by 4 is just 1 half. X divided by x squared just leaves us with x in the denominator, and y to the fourth divided by y to the third just leaves us with y in the numerator. Now let's evaluate that marginal rate of substitution at these values, plugging 18 in for y and 3 in for x. We get a marginal rate of substitution of 3. The consumer can replace 3 units of good y with 1 unit of good x, holding utility constant. That's the interpretation. Question 3, we have this utility function. It is a perfect substitutes utility function. What is the marginal utility of good x and good y? Marginal utility of good x is just this coefficient in front of the x term. It is just 2. Marginal utility of good y then is just 0.8, the coefficient in front of the y term. What is the slope of the consumer's indifference curve? The slope is given as minus the marginal utility of good x over the marginal utility of good y. So minus 2 divided by 0.8 is minus 2.5. This is just a straight downward sloping indifference curve. If the price of good x is $4, what is the marginal utility per dollar of good x? We're going to take the marginal utility of x, which is 2, and divide it by the price of x, which is 4, and we get 0.5. In other words, spending one more dollar on good x increases utility by half a unit. Question 4, derive the consumer's demand for good x as a function of the price of good x and income. We're going to use this utility function here. We saw that before. First thing I'm going to do is get the marginal utility of good x, which we saw earlier is this. We're going to get the marginal utility of good y, which we saw earlier is this. We're going to form the marginal rate of substitution, which we saw was y divided by 2x. We're going to set up the utility maximizing condition where the marginal rate of substitution equals the ratio of the prices. So marginal rate of substitution, y divided by 2 times x, equaling the ratio of the prices. Just rewriting that last step. And now we're going to solve for y. So multiplying everything through by 2x gives us this result right here. Let's create our budget constraint. So the budget constraint is a consumer's income equals the price of good x times units of good x plus the price of good y times units of good y. And now we're going to make a substitution where we have y here. We're going to replace it with this expression on top. So making that substitution, you'll notice that the price of good y divided by the price of good y, that'll just cancel, leaving us with this result here. Adding up the terms on the right-hand side, and now dividing through by 3 times the price of good x, that is the demand for good x. The demand for good x equals the consumer's income divided by 3 times the price of good x. Question 5, a consumer's utility function is given by u equals x squared times y to the fourth. Assume the consumer has $60 to spend on good x, priced at $2 per unit, and good y, which is priced at $1 per unit. What is the utility maximizing consumption bundle? All right, so we're going to get the marginal rate of substitution. So these are the same calculations we found earlier. Same marginal rate of substitution as we found earlier. We're going to set up the utility maximizing condition. Marginal rate of substitution equals the ratio of the prices. So we said the price of good x is $2, price of good y is $1. And now we're going to solve this for y. So 2x times 2 here gives us y equals 4x. Here's our budget constraint. The consumer has $60 to spend on good x, which is priced at $2, and good y, which is priced at $1. As before, we're going to make a substitution where we have y, we're going to replace that with 4x. Adding up the terms on the right-hand side, we get 6x equals 60, so x equals 10, so the consumer will buy 10 units of good x. As for good y, taking this 10 and plugging it into this expression here, y equals 4x, the consumer will buy 40 units of good y. So that is a utility maximizing consumption bundle. X equals 10, y equals 40. Question 6, consider this utility function. The consumer has $100 to spend on good x and good y. The price of good x is $8, and the price of good y is equal to $10. What is a utility maximizing consumption bundle? How much utility does the consumer get? So we're going to form the marginal utility of good x and divide that by the price of good x. So this marginal utility per dollar formation here. The marginal utility of good x is 80. The price of good x is 8. So we get marginal utility per dollar of 10. Doing a similar thing for good y, we're going to calculate the marginal utility of good y, which is just this coefficient on the y term, 120, divided by the price of good y, which is 10, and we get 12. So bigger numbers are better here. Spending a dollar on good y increases utility by 12 units versus spending a dollar on good x, which increases utility only by 10. So we get more bang for the buck by spending our money on good y. So the consumer will spend this entire $100 on good y. So the consumer always receives more utility per dollar from good y than good x. 12 is bigger than 10. The consumer should only purchase good y. How many units can this consumer afford? We take the consumer's income of 100 divided by the price of good y. The consumer can afford 10 units of good y, so y equals 10 and x equals 0 is a utility maximizing consumption bundle. This would be referred to as a corner solution. In terms of the level of utility the consumer gets at this consumption bundle, take our utility function, plug in 0 for x and 10 for y, and the consumer gets 1,200 units of satisfaction. Question 7, a consumer's utility function is given by the following. This is our perfect complement's utility function. Find the elbow or kink on the indifference curve at u equals 40. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that 40 and set it equal to 5x, and x equals 8. Then I'm going to take that 40 and set it equal to 8y, and solve for y, and y equals 5. So when x equals 8 and y equals 5, we're going to be on the elbow or kink of the indifference curve for u equals 40. We can just evaluate our utility function at those values. So 5 times 8, and then 8 times 5 are values for x and y. And we'll get the minimum of 40 and 40, which is just 40. So that would be the kink on the L-shaped indifference curve. Find 2 more consumption bundles on the indifference curve for u equals 40. So x equals 8 and y equals 6 would be another point. We could plug those values in our utility function up here. So 5 times 8 is 40. 8 times 6 is 48. The minimum of 40 and 48 is just 40. And here would be another point on the indifference curve where the consumer is just getting 40 units of satisfaction. If x equals 9, 5 times 9 is 45. If y equals 5, 8 times 5 is 40, which is the minimum of 45 and 40, just 40. So that consumption bundle would also give the consumer 40 units of satisfaction. Question 8, a consumer's utility function is given by the following, same as question 7. Assume the consumer has $52 to spend on good X and good Y. Each good is priced at $2. First thing we can do is form the budget constraint. The consumer's income equals the price of good X times units of good X plus the price of good Y times units of good Y. I'm going to take what we have in parentheses and set that equal to one another. 5X equals AY. I'm going to solve for X. You could also solve for Y. It doesn't matter. I'm just going to solve for X. So X equals 8/5 times Y. And now we're just going to plug this into our budget constraint where I have x. I'm just going to replace that with 8 divided by 5 times y. So here's our substitution. And now simplifying that. Simplifying some more. 16 divided by 5 is 3.2. Simplifying further. And 52 divided by 5.2 is 10. So y equals 10. Coming up here, we can calculate what x will equal. 8 divided by 5 times 10, the consumer will purchase 16 units of good X. So that is our utility maximizing consumption bundle. Y equals 10, X equals 16. Okay, that's it.